Buddhist spirituality art, the Vajrayana, the Diamond Way. There in the teachings given by Buddha to his most advanced disciples, the Tantras, we find a new concept of what representing the Buddha in visual form is about. Because the essence of the Tantras is that the Buddha nature, those qualities of wisdom, compassion, and power, are immanent in all beings and have always been there. So no longer is the Buddha something to be venerated and worshipped, even as a great exemplar for us. Buddha becomes, as it were, the symbol of what we already are, if we but knew it. And the methods of the Tantras, the Diamond Way, are about cultivating our innermost identity with that transcendental reality. What role does art play in that? Well, in the tantric system, art, whether it's the thangkas that we see, the scroll paintings, or the statues, they become templates for how the meditator must develop his or her inner awareness of their deepest nature, their Buddha nature. And as that Buddha nature is endlessly creative, then there are literally innumerable forms of Buddhahood that can be cultivated, each one leading us to our still transcendent center of being that transcends birth and death, but appearing in an infinite variety of ways, sometimes male, sometimes female, sometimes peaceful, sometimes energetic, sometimes loving, sometimes wise, sometimes powerful. That is the pantheon, that is the source of the pantheon of tantric deities. They all exist within us, but they must be cultivated by the tantric methods. So to respond to the need of the practitioners, the sculpture makers and the thangka painters of medieval India and then Nepal and finally Tibet produce this extraordinary work in which the meditator finds the template for refining his or her own vision, which of course refining is the essence of the tantric method, the sadhana, to learn to see ourselves and the world as it really is. So here in this exhibition, we can see work from the Gandhara period, where Buddha is portrayed confidently the first time as a human being, right through to the extraordinary rendition of Buddha as a deity of great power, great terror, great compassion, all these things which manifest the power of Buddhahood. In the tantric system, as you see here in this exhibition itself, the central concept, the central symbol is the refuge field, where the Buddha as human teacher, his Dharma in the form of scriptures, and the Sangha, the women and men who followed the Buddha's teachings, are our initial refuges, our initial contact with the reality of Buddhahood. But then we also have in this refuge field, represented here in this exhibition, the tantric inner realities, symbolized by the lamas, who are the roots of blessing, because they convey to us the power and the means of the Vajrayana. We then see the yidams, the peaceful, unwrathful deities, whose meditation practices we cultivate in order to discover our own nature. And finally, we see the root of activity, the dakinis and dharma protectors, who protect us from our own confusion and protect us from difficulties as we practice the path. The refuge field is the overarching unity of Buddhism, of Diamond Way Buddhism as practice, and of Diamond Way practice as art. So here we have it. I feel in a way that again, as with the wonderful happy happenstance of the first representation of the Buddha being in a way European inspired, it's also wonderfully inspiring that this first Buddhist curated, Buddhist produced exhibition of Buddhist art takes place in Lambeth, because as I tried to intimate earlier, Lambeth, of course, is home to one of England's sons who would have felt, I hope, completely at home here, William Blake, one of our greatest visionary poets and artists, whose whole work was dedicated to helping people clean the doors of perception. Because as he said, if the doors of perception be cleaned, everything will be seen as it is, infinite. And I'm sure old Billy Boy would also be wonderfully excited to see that his other beautiful line, energy is the eternal delight, is born out here and embodied in these timeless statues and thangkas. So my congratulations to all our brothers and sisters in the Diamond Way for this amazing show. As I said at the beginning, it's only sad that it's only 4 days. Let us hope there's another one. And let us hope also that we see more of this work to show how Buddhism has a role to play in modern civilization. Buddhism has much to say, not just about art, but about education and about philosophy, even indeed about science. And I know that it is part of Diamond Way's understanding of their work in Britain, as elsewhere, to make that interface happen. So congratulations to everybody. I'm really happy and delighted to have been here. Thank you.